Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Spotric Games. I'm your host, Spot, and I'm joined by Nub, the master engineer of all things Factorio, of course.
Hello.
And, of course, we have... you don't see him, because he's kind of our eye in the sky. The man known as Wacey. How are you, Wacey?
Drinking vodka.
It's a good day for Wacey. So Wacey's going to be in our ear, so he'll be listening to us dictate this crazy world that basically Nub's going to engineer, and I'm just going to try and support somehow. So what's our plan, Nub?
We need to get more things automated to make it easier.
So to make a long story short, Nub has went ahead and created, which you would have seen had some knucklehead not accidentally checked the wrong box, but you would have seen how he actually took the green line, split it. He's working on splitting the iron. It's going to come down here and create assembly machines, which will immediately get picked back up. Uh-oh, maybe. Wait a minute. What do we do with the extra cogwheels?
They should just sit there.
But your assembly machines won't get over.
Oh,
where are they going up? There we go.
I missed a piece. There we
go. Okay, okay. All's good. All's good. Okay, okay.
All's good.
See, I want it to be known. I totally helped the master engineer. Let it be documented.
Yes, yes. I can't catch everything. You can definitely help.
In that case, you guys missed my amazing helping. Quick recreation. La cucaracha, la cucaracha. There you go. I helped you up. Da 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 da.
Thank you. I needed that.
All right, I'll pick him up. So we are working on automating assembly machines. What's our immediate goal? Probably iron is still our biggest needed resource.
So we need iron. But since we're going for the achievement where you cannot craft more than 111 items in pocket, we just need to build everything out of machines.
The lazy bastard award, everybody.
Yeah, it's not so lazy. It's actually a little bit of work.
It's more of a patience game. Just it's like you
really
could
do
it.
So we have this giant iron field up here, but we don't have any miners to actually get anything from it. So I'm gonna go ahead and build.
You know what it kind of looks like from a distance? Like if you get in the center of the iron field and you zoom out. It kind of looks like a Boo Ghost from Nintendo.
Oh, yeah, it does.
It's kind of got the Boo feel.
I didn't notice that until now.
We're going to have to call it the Boo Mines.
The Boo Mines.
Well, that's all I got. I couldn't come up with anything more PG than that, so.
All right,
Spoopy
we'll
Mines.
It.
Spoopy. We can go a little spoop.
Spoopy Mines. All right, so I'm going to start another line down here because we're going to get something that I want to cut that right there.
Okay, fine.
We'll put it there. So this is just going to stop the iron from sitting down here and not being used for a little bit.
Okay.
Instead, it'll stop here at the splitter, but since there's already...
The smart aleck in me says, what about those two? These two are not getting used, Nub.
Which two? Yeah, what about those two?
See, Wacey understands. Huh?
Which two are you referring
These two,
to?
Right here at the bottom of the splitter, sir.
Oh, yeah, well, they're going to sit there. That's where they live now.
They have to suffer. Let's see.
I'm just kind of repeating what I was doing up there, because we're going to do a couple more things down here. Really, what does it take for...
Boy, lights. You're not kidding on our iron. Like, I'm sitting here watching this, and that is our biggest hang-up. Oof. I can throw another... There's enough room for another stone furnace if you want me to throw one down here.
Oh, yeah. If there's room on that section there.
I don't have any inserters. That's going to be up to you, apparently.
You know what? I have a few. I will... I'll just bring them up here since I'm right here. Power sticks. There you go. We'll move this whole furnace column somewhere else once we get it going.
And hopefully, I know it's just one, but maybe it'll help out a little bit with production here. Now we're making metal sticks.
I am making metal sticks because I'm making something that everybody will appreciate us for.
Oh my gosh, is that a light? Is that our optics?
That is a light box.
Well, I know my calling in life now.
Oh, I'm going to limit the chest
What are you pulling out?
So I'm not going to pull anything. So this is going to be a double side. I'm going to put another assembler right here.
Oh, okay. Okay.
But that if you leave kind of a two gap here, you can have a box and then things will plop into each box. Just a little bit saving on space. Okay, I'm actually
I know it goes against your wishes, but I dumped some extra iron into our assembly machine areas up here.
Oh yeah, that's fine. Assembly machines.
Well, I just know that's like huge anti-automation, so I just had to make sure you felt what we're doing there.
I will accept it. Oh. Yep, bad news. Any more splitters?
You had those being crafted somewhere, didn't you?
I thought I did, but apparently not. Also, I'm gonna need more,
Plenty of conveyor belts. Lots of conveyor belts.
Yeah, we'll need those quite soon. Oops, that is not what I wanted to put there. That's supposed to be gears. Alright, so this is where we get to the part where we just need to build more stuff for automation.
We need more iron. We need lots more iron.
Yeah, it comes down to iron right now. I also need...
Realistically, though, we have as much... We have as much as we can, though. Shy of splitting the line and taking it into a different furnace area. We'd almost have to create a second furnace row.
Yeah.
Which it looks... Because that's copper. Our poor coal train here has no other purpose other than to just feed our fire right now.
That's all it does. It'll be great at it.
I guess, refresher, in case you have not seen any of the previous episodes, down here is what we will have as a steam power row here. Plenty of boilers, all of them being properly fed. What do we got? We have a cat chewing up carpet. That's what we have.
We have a cat,
ladies and gentlemen. Titan. Anyway, let's see. As I was saying, gosh, cat, stop. Home studio, folks. We're professional. Okay, moving on. As I was saying, cat, we've got 10 steam engines down here. Plenty of power right now. Satisfaction is we're about making 3/4 more than what we actually need.
Meow.
Meow. Okay. Well, we'll cut a lot of that out. Okay. I had a quick optical illusion. It almost looked as I was passing by that we didn't have water going to the boiler, so I was kind of curious how that was working, but never mind. The shadow kind of blended in with the underground pipe.
I am trying to get some more power poles.
Well, you got it. Yeah, see, you got them. You've got them cooking right there.
Yeah, so this is going to be a kind of an automation, but we need to get some more...
Are you kidding me, cat? You want back out... Go, cat.
Yeah, kay. Kitty wants in.
You came, you saw your carpet. Have fun, go play, don't... Freaking cat is doing a number on the carpet, man.
There you go. Alright, got some power pole automation.
Do you need any more lumber?
Not right now. We're okay for now.
Oh, we got 390. We're okay. All right. Look at us go. Okay.
Got it. There we go. Had to attach one spot. So there we go. Now we have optics being made.
And
we can light up.
Oh.
Light things up. There we go. Fantastic. Game gets really dark at night. And without lights, it's, I just get used to it, but it makes it really hard for everyone on YouTube to see anything. So I've got some drills being made over here.
You're doing good. See, I am raining down light. We actually are going to be able to see around our farm.
We don't have a farm. I hate to break it to you.
We could.
This is not a farm.
We could. It's a tragedy. The cat that was tearing up the carpet is getting his nails clipped. So I am scattering as many of these lights as I can within scattering is a better word. I don't really have a strategy for them, which I'm sure will drive you nuts later.
Oh, probably. We're almost ready to start an actual furnace column. Almost.
Now yeah. You're teasing. All right, so I am going to try and get a light by generally every other pole to see if that will help here. Oh, no, I dropped two lights. All right. So we are going to, well, I guess we can't really tell until nighttime hits, but I think with everything that you're giving me, we're going to be just fine.
I'm trying to get some more stuff up here automated. We need some pipes, which is what I'm trying to do. But before I can get pipes made, we need some more stuff.
And pipes are going to be...
I'm also doing a twofold thing, because these pipes will turn into boilers.
Okay, so that way we can create another
because we
power
need
train.
Boilers, yeah, for more power.
You must construct more pylons. Obscure reference.
What was that?
I was getting more of a Tim Allen vibe.
Arf, 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 arf. Let's see. Oh, no more lights? Why no more lights? Oh, because no more iron.
Yeah, you know, typical thing.
Really, that's been, if we have one theme for this entire run, it's we need more iron. I always forget. Oh, those are electric mining drills. Oh, look at you with the electric mining drills.
Yeah, so there's electric mining drills down there that should be automated so we can start to tap into more iron.
Okay.
There's also inserters.
Well, I grabbed 9 of the electric miners. Do you want me to just kind of go down the line? Yeah, plenty of time. I'll join onto your line that you have going on here.
Yeah, so they fit perfectly with the power poles if you do 2 and then a power pole on the end.
Okay. Now, power poles...
That way it powers... actually, right here, you can put these right next to the pole like this.
Okay. Now, I thought you didn't want to usually double up. Because doesn't it grab one in the middle?
I've changed my theories about that.
Oh, well then.
If you jam it all together like this, it actually gives more throughput. So, the way it's down there...
Listen to
it's,
you,
it, Mr. No, it's like
Mr.
this.
Throughpoint, or throughput.
Nope. Okay. I'll let you do that.
I'm doing good.
I'm going to go back down here.
I'm doing good. See? I did good. I did a thing.
Back down here. I'm gonna fix things.
Oh, I see. Okay, I see what I did. It just took me a minute. I may have not put it in a straight row. That's okay. I appreciate you letting me learn from my own lessons. Oh, I see what you're doing. 2 together. Okay, capiche. Okay. I am slowly learning. Power poles are definitely going to be a necessity, though. All right, so I've got 1, 2.
There's power poles up here.
Okay, so now I should be able to go 1, and then put 2. Okay, that makes sense. I'm getting there. And I will make sure to drop this down. People at home watching this are probably like, well, Spot's about a quarter effective as Caleb is at this. So, I have lights. I'll be dropping lights. I have... you said power poles are being created there.
Yeah, they're up there.
And I have more mines. So, I'm gonna expand our mine... Or our... No, you know why we don't have more mines yet? Or more miners, I should say, the electric drills?
Yeah, because that's not the holdup right now.
Although, they are working beautifully.
It
looks very pretty.
They're working amazingly.
There's one. All right, so that one's too close. Okay. I am finally catching what you're throwing. Man, took me long enough. Okay, there we go. So now we have... at least a few more feeds, but you're right, our choke points, the burners. So with the burners being our choke point, what would be the easiest? Would we basically just do a split off of the line up here and feed a whole bunch more?
The easiest is just to build a proper smelting area.
So does that mean we have to undo all that we have done here?
Eventually, but not right this second.
Eventually.
Yeah.
Let's see, so 1, 2. Alright, 1, 2. Alright. We're getting lights everywhere, man. I want you to know, I am illuminating us as we speak. Oh, if I can get not stuck in a tree. Oh, I'm stuck in a tree. Okay, I'm good now. I'm good. I do wish I was exaggerating, but the tree did win that fight.
Tree won, huh?
Yeah. It was decently tragic. Okay, so there's our lone copper organization lit up a little bit. Boy, I forget how quick sometimes it will register you dropping something. I keep going to put one light and end up dropping like two of them.
Yeah, it does go pretty quick. Alright, there's some more automation down there for us. Oh, right, that's why I had that there.
Okay, you remembered a thing?
Yeah, I didn't realize why we had something where it was, and I just figured out why it was there. But I'm just shifting things around a little bit.
You got this, man.
Make it work.
You're going to be so proud. When night hits and you can still see everything, you're going to be like, you did good, kid.
I will be happy. Yeah.
Let's see. The only place is not illuminated. Let's see. All right. We'll go boom. And then we'll go boom. Here, yep. I'm feeling good. You are just going to be like, wow. The lighting on this map. You're going to be like, all those years of stage crew paid off for you, man. Oh, man. I almost had something beautiful there, and then it all broke on me, Nub.
Oh.
Goo. I'm not going to lie. The visual of trying to determine where in the minefield up here that I can place things is a little intense. It all looks the same. There we go. Okay.
Yeah, it kind of.
Oh, my shining light. My shining moment. Everybody. Wacey, I know you can't see this right now, but just know, it looks glorious.
There was a moment when I was thinking about offering to hop into your stream there so I could, make relevant commentary. But
well, it's not too late.
Then I also thought, what if I just kept playing video games?
And video games won?
Oh, yeah.
As it should. And what is Wacey playing tonight, man?
I'm playing Skyrim because,
can't get enough.
There's always something standing in the way of me playing D&D. Can I swear on this thing?
Go ahead.
I needed something to fill a void in my life that was filled with some fantasy bullshit. I've been waiting at least 2 months. Probably more if we count your last campaign.
Okay.
To play some Dungeons and Dragons.
So you're jonesing a touch.
I'm jonesing a touch.
Well then, you say Chad's campaign is starting up here soon, right?
Yeah. I'm a rogue. I've never played a rogue.
You're gonna be just fine.
I always thought I'd be an assassin if I was going to do a 5th edition rogue, but then I started reading Thief and, like, man, 13th level, you get use magic device, DM's like, here's a mysterious item. You better figure out how to use it if you want to use it, but now I can just go, no, I use it.
I like
it. Find a mysterious staff. I point it at a wall. I activate it.
Yeah.
What does it do?
You need yourself some D&D.
Oh, yeah, I do. I don't know if you heard, my character's Batman.
True story.
That's beautiful. Is it similar to the story, the one you sent me for our campaign?
Similar, yes, except a gun wasn't involved.
Okay. Was it a crossbow?
Daniel Bateman.
Was a crossbow involved, at least?
I don't know. I wasn't there for it. I just came back to my father's body.
Oh.
My father's body and our family name sitting over the hearth. The eye conveniently covered in blood, so it simply read Batman.
And thus, Batman is born. I approve, man. I greatly approve. Watch this. Well, if you could see this, Wacey, you'd be proud. I'm helping Nub. I helped him. See me helping?
Oh, yeah, that's real helpful there, Spot.
Yep.
Thank you.
Yep, I'm gonna go over here.
So,
the most condescending way I could have said that.
Thank you. I wasn't getting enough from Nub, so I figured if I turned to you, you could fill the void there, man.
Of course, I can get more condescending if you want.
Could I use a fifth of that? One more fifth of condescension, please.
That's nice, dear.
Well done. So Wacey's feeling good.
I'm feeling pretty all right.
Yep. You got it.
That's the way to be, man. That's the way to be.
Sarah, my girlfriend, for, you know, those watching at home, has a lot of people who are worse at her job who try to tell her how to do her job, and I'm pushing real hard to get her to drop that on someone.
But you know what? I completely avoided time. Guess what time it is, Nub?
Oh, is it that time?
It's that time. We got one episode
down. I just got
down.
The building, you know. I've been automating things and building more things, and look, I kind of fixed the iron problem.
Well,
You
should give a quick breakdown. What did you do? If you had to look back and see what you did, because I can tell you expanded the burn line, it looks like.
So I expanded the furnace line to get some more iron producing. Of course, we built all of this automation down here for some common things. And then over here, I've expanded our belt making to include the splitters and underground belts.
Okay, nice.
There's some power poles being made up here and some boxes. And then we've got some pipes, boilers, and the steam engines produced up here.
Nice. And I don't want to toot my own horn, but it's so nice to see things at night now.
And yes, we can see it. It's great.
All right. Well, that's going to do it for this episode of Factorio here at Spotric Games. I'm your host, Spot. And, of course, we have the Nub taking care of all the engineering needs of any Factorio game ever. Any parting words?
Nope. Just going to go build some more stuff.
Okay. Wazy, any parting words from you, sir?
Nope.
Excellent answer. Have a great day, everybody. You deserve it. We'll catch you in the next episode. Bye-bye.